You having a good time?
2019, representing Texas.
There it is, you heard it first.
I mean, we went through 62 tons last year. It's a daunting task.
We can change. We don't need harm environment to keep our traditions.
We're here in New Orleans, Louisiana for Mardi Gras 2019.
We are. I'm giving my stethoscope.
Yeah, that'd be sweet.
We're here in New Orleans, Louisiana for Mardi Gras 2019, where everyone's on a diehard mission to collect as many beads as possible. In fact, last year there were so many beads that nearly 93,000 pounds of them ended up in the sewers across just a couple of blocks of the parade route.
Individual beads are strung together to become Mardi Gras throws and tossed from parade floats among other plastic trinkets and accessories. It is one of the most well-known parade traditions, and most participants recognize that it creates an environmental problem, but many are apathetic toward it.
What do you think happens to the beads that don't end up in the trees from someone with such an incredible arm like yourself?
I feel like they get picked up and they end up in a landfill or recycled. I mean, I have an attic filled with that shit.
A lot of ways. I guarantee you, if they can recycle beads, they won't have to make no more for years.
It's hard to ignore when you see the aftermath of the parades. When you're walking down the street, and there's just like beads, and there's like plastic bags from what people were throwing, just like laid out on the street.
Live here?
We are. Are you live? Because we're live.
I'm reporting live here. Yeah.
I get every girl putting a lot of beads on me.
Why? Because you got to earn the beads.
Because I'm so hot.
Tell me, why? What's so important about this throw? What would it mean to you if you caught that throw up?
It would mean everything!
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 Beads!
We are in Mardi Gras. We're turned. Are y'all turned? Y'all want to take a shot or no? Shot! 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 Shot!
About a lot of these beads is they get clogged in the sewers. Last year, a $7 million emergency contract needed to relieve 15,000 clogged catch basins.
But luckily, two local organizations have taken it upon themselves to collect as many beads off the streets as possible, recycle them, and then resell them for next year's Mardi Gras.
This program with people with mental disabilities, such as me, who wants out here to get a job and enjoy stuff like this as well. I do it from the heart, and I do it because I love to. And I want to give my heart out to people who can do this.
For the past 2 years, Art G&O has teamed up with the Youth Leadership Council of New Orleans to recycle beads after a few selected parades, along with other recyclables such as cans and plastic bottles.
Last year was our pilot year. We'll come this year, twice as many parades, and better weather than last year, too.
What happens when you put beads in a pile? Not. And it's frustrating, so we have to learn patience, control, working with other people with intellectual disabilities at the same time. So it is fun, and I'm profoundly grateful to be able to be a part of it. I mean, we went through 62 tons last year. It's a daunting task. We're so excited that the awareness that people are buying into recycling. Well, it's a little bit of a misnomer. We're reusing. I would love to say these are not going to go in the landfill. At the end of the day, when they're grody and nasty and the color's all worn out, they will go into the landfill. I like telling people that because some smart person is going to create a biodegradable bead. But until then, we're proud that we get to reuse these. Reuse them, help our environment, and provide jobs for these wonderful people.
This one is the bead which I detached from Mardi Gras beads. And this one is what we created. It's 100% algae biomass. It's hard and weight is very similar. And then this one I manually painted to make sure if you want shinier ones, you can do it too. My name is Naohiro Katos. and I am an associate professor at the LSU. The biggest challenge is that any bioplastics costs about 10 times more than regular plastics. The person who purchased Mardi Gras beads, the Mardi Gras clues, which a regular person like you and me, just wants to have fun. We don't expect any return. So the goal becomes how we can reduce the cost to produce biodegradable plastics. And I quickly learned that algae, once I'm working on actually a big producer of oil, that can convert to plastic easily. I don't think we can replace all Mardi Gras beads to biodegradables, and I think it's not necessary. This summer, we plan to produce first batch of biodegradable Mardi Gras beads, which only about 3,000 necklaces. So my hope is that once people catch the biodegradable beads, that people start thinking, why this guy is throwing biodegradable beads? And then why I want to keep this one, but not other ones? So I think it's important to keep celebrate Mardi Gras beads. That's one of the greatest cultures the Louisiana uniquely have. We can change. We don't need to harm environment to keep our traditions.
From Locomotives, this is Louisiana. We are talking about environmental issues. As you can see, turn around, plastic everywhere. We are all stopped. We are all part of the problem. Plastic is everywhere.
Thank you, man.